wasn't in my own city. I was in a different city. I was like very far away. I wasn't even in my own country. I think I was in the States. I remember I was with a man and a woman. I think I figured out by the end that we were both somehow related to the police force or something like that. I don't know. It makes no sense, but anyway, I was in this other city, and all I remember is being in a room. I don't know if we were sharing a hotel or sharing a suite or booking in a house or something. I don't know, but we were all in a bedroom. I think there's two guys that I had apparently slept with. I don't know if I had actually had a relationship with them, if they were actually a boyfriend or what. There's two guys that I had slept with, and one of them was rejected. Apparently it really turned his life upside down. And he was very protected by his mother. Well, his mother was hiding in the closet that night when I was there with me and my two friends, this other guy and this other girl. They knew, they come to know that she's in the closet. So they're hiding. I'm hiding under the damn blanket on my bed. Like, as if that's going to do a world of good, right? Trying to peek out from the edge of the bed cover to see if, you know, if anything starts happening or if anybody starts moving, but hoping that nobody can see me hiding under the blanket. How ridiculous is that? But, you know, scared people, they'll do anything. They can start to think anything. So anyway, we got the lights off, and I'm hiding under the blanket, and one guy's hiding by the door, and the woman is hiding not too far from him. I decided to get brave after a while, and I creeped out. Nobody was moving, nobody was doing anything, and this person was in the closet. You could see white socks kind of stick out like a sore thumb in the bottom of the closet. So you could tell that somebody was in there. But it was so dark with the lights off, and the person was all in black, and there's black stuff in the closet. Hid them pretty well, except for the white socks. If you looked hard enough, you could see it. Anyway, I get out of the bed, and I go towards the door, which is where this one of my friends is by the door hiding. And we just know she wants to kill us. You know, so I'm trying to talk as quiet as I can so that she can't hear me, and I'm telling my friend, you know, look, I don't know where the phone is, and we can't make any loud noises or sudden moves. But if you have a cell phone, you know, if you have a cell phone that doesn't make sound when you turn it on, or it doesn't make a sound when you dial or something, turn the volume off. Let's call 911. Apparently nobody had thought of that. So I told, anyway, this guy takes out a cell phone and he gives it to me. Flips it open. And he flips it open and he hands it to me, and we dial 911, and they come on the line, and I'm whispering, right? I'm like, she's in the closet. She wants to kill us all. There's three of us here. We need somebody now. I don't remember what the 911 guy was saying, because as soon as I said that, I turn around, and she's right behind me, right beside me. It's one of those moments where if you could jump out of your skin, literally, that would be it. I can't imagine the fear, ever feeling that fear ever in my life. She takes the phone and grabs hold of me and that's when I realized it was just me and her. She had gotten to my friends already. And their bodies are laying wherever they were in the room. I couldn't see them at the time, but it all happened so fast. She had me by the arm. I saw her move, and I felt something in my throat, and I saw a flash, like a flash of silver. And I was convinced that eventually, if I didn't watch, that she was going to cut my throat. What I didn't realize was that she had it's kind of like an ice pick, and she had already stabbed my throat. This is what she had done to my friends, too. So I start bleeding. She leaves me on the bed. So we're just basically just waiting to die. You know, and I remember hearing her make a comment that I was lucky compared to my friends. She said it's slower, but it's not as painful. And she said I couldn't. I couldn't feel it as much, not to be scared.